Former British Prime Minister Tony Blair said on Friday that the West needs to prepare for possible war with Iran. As special envoy to the Middle East for the International Quartet, Blair has seen the hand of Iran behind Hezbollah in Lebanon and Hamas in Gaza. It appears that Blair is losing hope for a peaceful resolution to the Iranian conflict. It's time for politics and religion.
Look, there are two things I don't discuss, politics and religion.
In my house, we don't talk about politics and we don't talk about religion.
I'll talk to you about anything except politics and religion.
I never talk about politics and religion.
Politics determines how we'll live here on Earth. Religion determines how we'll live forever. I'm Irvin Baxter. I think it's time we talk about it.
Nuclear talks were held between Iran and the Big Five plus one last weekend on Friday and Saturday. Out of that meeting, Mr. Tony Blair had remarks to make. Let me just read to you the first paragraph of the article. And perhaps the sharpest warning about the impending danger from Iran's nuclear program ever issued by a Western leader. Former British Prime Minister Tony Blair said Friday that the West needed to prepare for a possible war with Iran. Now, let's put this in perspective. We've been wrestling with this situation with Iran now for many years. It's been on again, off again. There have been threats, counter threats. Israel's made trial runs to Greece and back, which is the same distance as it is to Iran and back. The reports have been made that Israel actually landed aircraft in Saudi Arabia, had the permission of Saudi Arabia to land there for refueling and use that as a launching point for an attack against Iran. Many other countries have pledged their cooperation because the entire region does not want Iran to have nuclear weaponry. They see this as a make or break situation. They see it as a situation if Iran gets a hold of nuclear weapons, she will use the tremendously escalated influence that would be acquired by such a development to dominate the entire region. They do not want to be under Iranian domination. And of course, Iranian domination means the domination of the hard-line Muslim leaders of Iran, the Ayatollah Khomeinis of our day. So that's where we are right now. The Arab world doesn't want it. The Iranian president, Mahmoud Abbas, has said repeatedly that Iran, that Israel must be wiped off the map. Israel sitting here watching them try to develop a nuclear bomb. They don't have to have 14 of them. They only need one. Israel is a one-bomb state. One bomb on Tel Aviv makes the entire state uninhabitable. It's over. End. That's the reason Israel says repeatedly that Iran is an existential threat for the nation of Israel. But now then we have a man who's considered somewhat moderate. He is considered one of the premier leaders of the last 10, 15 years. I mean, when you say Tony Blair, you're saying Bill Clinton. You're talking about a leader that has a stature far and above. He'd be one of the top four names, I suppose, of people who are considered statesmen, even though he no longer holds the position of prime minister in Great Britain. He is still the special envoy to the Middle East for the Quartet. The Quartet, of course, is that those four powers representing the entire world that crafted a peace agreement for the nation of Israel. They have not yet been able to deliver on that peace agreement, but nonetheless, Tony Blair is very much involved. He very recently struck a deal with Bill Clinton and the Clinton Global Initiative to install a curriculum around the world for interfaithism. They are starting a program called Face to Faith, where they intend for Christians to speak to Muslims by way of computer, or to Buddhists, or to Zoroastrians, or to Wiccans, or to indigenous people. And they want all this interaction so that the people over there can see that we're not so bad and we can understand them better, and openness will cultivate understanding, and understanding therefore removes conflict. So anyway, all I'm telling you is that Mr. Tony Blair is considered one of the top peacemakers, diplomats. He's very involved in faith and globalization. He has a curriculum at Yale University, and now it's spread into other universities. The curriculum is called Faith and Globalization. You actually can get a degree in faith and globalization, and he is guest lecturer. So he's looked up to as one of the premier peacemakers. Mr. Tony Blair presided over the peace in Northern Ireland, and so everybody's looking at this. Well, we have this meeting on Friday and Saturday to try to get a breakthrough where Iran is concerned, as it has to do with the development of nuclear power. Now, most of the world believes that Iran has a goal of developing nuclear weaponry. Iran says, oh, no, no, we don't. However, Iran lied before. When a person lies to you once, you tend to think they may lie to you again. Way back in 2003, they had a secret nuclear program developing. The whole world knows this. Iran itself has admitted it. But when George Bush went in and invaded Iraq, Iran got scared and said, we're stopping, we're out. However, Iran is back, and she is developing nuclear capability. Now, they say they only want the nuclear fuel for domestic power. However, they've already admitted now enriching uranium to like 20% enrichment. You only need like 4% enrichment for nuclear power. So why the 20%? Oh, we wanted to do some medical experiments. Now they're boasting that they could enrich uranium all the way to the 90% that's required for a nuclear weapon. And so the beat goes on. The U.S. does not want another war. Israel does not want a war. Nobody knows what will happen. Iran says repeatedly, if we are attacked by Israel or the U.S., it will produce World War III. Nobody wants World War III. And yet, Tony Blair, having worked as special envoy to the Middle East from the Quartet, he has talked to Syria, he's talked to Lebanon, he has talked to Egypt, he's talked to the Palestinians, the Jordanians, the Israelis, and this man who has been immersed in the Middle East, he actually maintains a home in Jerusalem. One of the big meetings he was attending not too long ago, they asked for his home, and he signed it Jerusalem, Israel, or Jerusalem at least. So here's this man that's in the know, prime minister of Great Britain for 10 years. He has contacts at the very highest level around the world. And what is he saying? It's time for the West to prepare for war. Let me read it one more time because it's so very important. And perhaps the sharpest warning about the impending danger from Iran's nuclear program ever issued by a Western leader, former British Prime Minister Tony Blair, said Friday that the West needed to prepare for a possible war with Iran. He went on to say, extremism can't be managed. It has to be confronted and changed. Now, just in case you've not been keeping up with it, let me remind you what Iran has been doing. Iran has a declared war on the nation of Israel. Iran gave $50 billion last year to Hezbollah in Lebanon, and Hezbollah vows that Israel will be wiped off the map. They also have funded Hamas in Gaza, smuggling in rockets. Right now, it is claimed that Hezbollah has 40,000 rockets trained on Israel, rockets much stronger with longer range than Hezbollah has ever had before, rockets that can reach all the way to Tel Aviv. That means they can reach Haifa, they can reach all the villages of the Sea of Galilee, they can reach all the way to Tel Aviv. Now you think about this. So you have one of your greatest population centers. It's the business capital of Israel. It's the secular capital of Israel, Tel Aviv. And you have them sitting there under the threat of 40,000 rockets. Now, they only have a population in the entire nation of Israel of 7 million. 40,000 rockets raining down on Tel Aviv. What happens when this happens? When all this comes to pass? And that's the power that's funding all this. Without Iran, Hezbollah goes away, cannot survive. Without Iran, Hamas cannot survive. They are the funding. They're using their oil. I guess the reason they don't want to use their oil for gasoline is because they want to sell it to fund their war-making capability. I don't know. That may be the reason. But nobody really believes them when they say, well, we need nuclear fuel for domestic consumption. And Iran is what? The second or third largest oil reserves in the whole world. Why do they need nuclear power? As a matter of fact, would you like to know how much gasoline is in Iran? Can you believe 10 cents a gallon? That's all. 10 cents a gallon. It's amazing. Well, okay. Why do I bring it up? Because there's this prophecy in the Bible that a war is coming out of the Middle East. The Bible says it will emanate from the Euphrates River. Iraq and Iran make up the Euphrates River basin. And the Bible says in Revelation chapter 9, verse 13 through 20, that a war will start there. Now, this is not going to be a normal war. It is going to be the worst war mankind has ever known. Not by a little bit, but 40 times as bad as the worst war we've ever known. 40 times World War II. Do you realize that there had never been a war prior to the 20th century with 1 million fatalities? Never been a war with 1 million dead. World War I comes along, 8.2 million dead. The whole world gasped when they added up the totals. They called it the Great War. We can never allow this to happen again, but it did happen again 20 short years later. This time, not 8 million dead, 52 million. So here we have mankind from the beginning of history until the 20th century. Never a war with 1 million dead. And then comes World War I, 8 million. World War II, 52 million. And ladies and gentlemen, I dare you to open your Bible to Revelation chapter 9, verse number 15. It explicitly states there that a war is coming that will kill one-third of mankind. One-third of 6.8 billion. That's somewhere around 2.2 or 2.3 billion. That's the reason when Tony Blair says it's time for the West to prepare for war against Iran. Well, it is alarming. And that's putting it very mildly.
Every Monday at 9 p.m. Central on the Church Channel and at 10 p.m. Central on Daystar, Irvin Baxter presents End of the Age. End of the Age is a 30-minute program which gives intricate details about how Bible prophecy is not only true, but also how it lines up so perfectly with events going on in the world right now. Don't miss one End of the Age program every Monday at 9 p.m. Central on the Church Channel and at 10 p.m. Central on Daystar. Visit endtime.com for more details or call 1-800-END-TIME.
When you think about Bible prophecy or the end of the world, what comes to mind? War, destruction, famine, disease, 666, Mark of the Beast, Antichrist, False Prophet, Four Horsemen, Trumpets, Seals, and Vials. What about 2012? How does all of this affect you as a teenager in today's world? Those are all good questions, but the thing to remember is that Bible prophecy was not put here for us to be afraid of it, but for us to know what is to come. When I was a kid, I used to pretend that I could see the future and predict